Good morning, Greater Love family and friends. We just want to thank you for being here this morning to hear the word of God, and we come to wish and pray and uplift the name of Jesus. This is the day the Lord has made. We're going to rejoice.
Hallelujah.
And pray. Can I get with somebody who knows by your grace and mercy that God allowed us to see one more day that wasn't promised to us. And that's enough to say thank you for this day.
Thank you,
Lord. For allowing us one more day to be among the living. We woke up this morning and our right from the mind will cause your health and strength. And somebody should say, praise God.
Praise God.
It's so good to us.
Oh, yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
The scripture today will come from Matthew chapter 4, verse 1 through 4. Then when Jesus led up of the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. And he went and had fast 40 days and 40 nights. He was afterward in hunger. And when the tempter came to him, he said, if thou art the Son of God, command these stones to be made bread. But Jesus answered and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceed out of the mouth of God. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceed out of the mouth of God. We thank you, God. Oh, we thank you, God. It's your word that got to feed us every day. We got to have some spiritual food to stay in this race, to stay focused. May God bless the hearers, the doers of his holy word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come.
Yes, Lord, yes.
As humble servants bow.
Yes.
As humble as we know how.
Yes.
Thank you, God, for allowing us to come into your house of worship as one more time.
One more time.
God, we pray in the name of Jesus that you will fall fresh in this place.
Yes.
Like never before.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Have thine own way, oh God.
Have your way.
Because, oh God, we realize, oh God, that we can't do nothing.
Nothing without you.
Until you come.
Yes, yes.
So God, we pray and ask, oh God, that you would come and sit with us.
Please, Heavenly Father, help us.
Just for a little while.
Yes, a little while.
So God, we pray in the name of Jesus that you would bless this land and this country.
Yes.
Move by your spirit like never before, oh God. We understand what's going on in the world, oh God. But most of all, oh God, we thank you, oh God, for a God that sits high and look low. God, we come praying for our pastor and his family. God, hide him behind your secret desk. Teach him what he ought to say on today. Oh, how we need a word on today, oh God. In the mighty precious name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise. Give him a praise and praise. Amen. For he deserves the highest.
Believe in the word of God. desire to give, bless one gave, Heavenly Father. But let these tithes all be used for the going on your kingdom here on earth as it is in heaven, Lord. We thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
God deserves the highest
praise. Every morning that we wake up and have activities of all our lives, we all give God our praise. Every morning that we get up and we have breath in our bodies, we ought to give God a crazy praise. Everywhere I go, because He deserves the highest praise. There's a lot of people I can give thanks to. There's a lot of people I can be grateful for. But only one person I can give highest praise. That's Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Church family, we have a special treat.
Amen.
This morning, we have an anointed young lady of God, praise dancer, that's going to come and just give her all on the altar and dance today. I would like for Sister Karen White, director, praise dance director, to come up and introduce our special guest.
Amen.
Giving out praises to God. I don't need a mic. Giving out praises to God. I'm truly the head of my life. I don't take nothing for granted. I thank God for the opportunity that I'm able to step in His house. I know what He's doing with this pandemic, but you know what? We're here because He helped us.
I thank Him. I give Him glory. No matter what goes on in my life, I give Him glory.
I'm supposed to be introducing Melody, but when I think about the goodness,
Ma'am,
yes, ma'am.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Man, that's the best.
Oh, we need you.
Yes, God.
Yes, we do.
Yes, we do.
Okay.
Let us say amen. Let us say amen again. If you in this house, in the house of God today, you know that God has been good to you, you ought to give God a hand clap of praise. And know that you're nobody special, but you were special on his list. That he allowed you and I just to be here in the house just one more time. Come on, y'all. People are dying. Folks are going on to be with the Lord. But the Lord has allowed us to be here one more time. And we thank God for his goodness. And we thank him for his mercy. Because he didn't have to allow us to be here. Let us pray. Father, we come now and we come in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we thank you. Thank you for life, health, and strength.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for things being as well as it is. Thank you most of all, God, for your protection.
Thank you, Lord.
For your word that you have given us. We have pleaded the blood over the doorpost, God, and I thank you that in this house you have protected us.
Yes,
and God, I mean, in the midst of this pandemic, you have been so good to us. And God, we cannot help but to say thank you. Because we are here, God. We're here. You've given us just another chance. And we won't take it for granted. We say thank you. Now, God, we come to decrease in order that you increase. Teach us what to say and how to say it in this hour. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
If you have your Bibles, we're going back. And we're in a series of going back to Deuteronomy chapter 11. And we're going to read three verses to you. Out of Deuteronomy chapter 11, beginning at verse 10. And the Bible says, for the land whither thou goest in to possess it is not as the land of Egypt, from which ye came out, where thou sowest thy seed and watereth it with thy foot, as a garden of herbs. But the land whither ye go to possess it is a land of hills and valleys, and drinketh water of the rain of heaven, a land which the Lord thy God careth for, the land which the Lord thy God careth for, the eyes of the Lord thy God are always upon it, from the beginning of the years even unto the end of the year. Remember what we told you. We told you in our theme for this year at the Greater Love Baptist Church, we said a word for the new year, and our subtitle was, I'm leaving this place and I'm not coming back.
Yes,
well, I'm leaving this place and I'm not going back. I'm leaving this place. You may be seated. I'm leaving this place and I'm not going back. Somebody gonna get that after a while. I'm leaving this place and I'm not going back. When you look at this particular chapter in Deuteronomy chapter 11, it's talking about obedience. He already shared with us in the text about the Red Sea, how he brought them through that. And then he told us that we got to be obedient to the commandment of God. And so if you want to eat everything that I'm about to talk about, you got to be obedient to the word of God. Look at your name and say, it's all about obedience in this year. In this year, it's all about your obedience to the Lord. And when you are obedient to God, listen, you can eat the good things of the land. Because God has given us everything. Help me, Lord Jesus. And all we got to do is be obedient to the word. In other words, follow the word of God, and God will give you everything you want. Help me here, somebody. So last week we tried to tell you
when you're leaving one place and going to another. See, Egypt was a place of dryness, no water. Things were happening bad in Egypt. But then when you get to Canaan, everything starts to flourish. But what I want to share with you this morning, and I only want to talk about in the text, I want to talk about, watch this. I want to talk about this word, whether ye go, watch this. Whether ye go to possess it is a land of hills and valleys. And I want to stay right there, hills and valleys. Because when you're trying to leave Egypt and get to Canaan, what the text is saying, that you're going to have some mountains. Help me, Lord Jesus. Is it in your Bible? And my Bible says hills and valley. But I want to change to the mountains. You're going to have some mountains and you're going to have some valleys. Can I get a witness here? So in other words, I'm trying to leave Egypt. I'm trying to leave Egypt right here. And I'm on my way to Canaan. But you're just not going to step from Egypt and step into Canaan. The Bible says you're going to have some mountains or some hills. And you're going to have some valleys. Because everybody don't want to go to Canaan. Everybody in Egypt don't want to go to Canaan. You better hear me this morning. Some people don't want to go to Canaan. Some people would rather stay in Egypt because you relax in Egypt. But I come by to tell you this morning, you ought to get out of Egypt and be on your way to Canaan. See, because in Egypt, watch me here. I'm coming to the church. In Egypt, and some of us in Egypt, you rather sit there because you used to talking about people. You used to dogging folks out. You ain't saying nothing. You used to saying all of them devilish things. You want to stay right there in Egypt, but somebody want to go to Canaan. And if you're on your way to Canaan, those in Egypt will try to hold you back. Oh, God have mercy. Because if I'm on my way to Canaan, and you want to stay in Egypt, you want me to stay in Egypt with you. Because misery likes company. See, if I'm miserable on this end, I want you to stay with me because I need you to accompany me. But I'm on my way to Canaan because ain't nothing good happening in Egypt. And so watch this now. Watch me here. I want to tell you now something. This year, you will face some mountains and go through some valleys. I'm telling you something. This year, you're going to face some mountains and you're going to go through some valleys. We've left 2020 and we're in 2021. Don't think every time you hear some 2020. 2020 was a bad year and we're in 2021. But don't think that you ain't gonna have no trials and you ain't gonna have no tribulation. The Bible says we're gonna have trials and we're going to have tribulation. And so you're going to have some mountains and you're going to have some valleys. But how many of you know you need both of them? You need both of them. You need both the mountains and the valleys. Why? Why, Pastor Grant? Because the strength gained from climbing and conquering the last mountain is what will get you through the next valley. See the strength. You climbing the mountains. Watch me here. Girl, they. You on a mountain now because you in Egypt. And you trying to go to Canaan. It's a valley. It's a valley. And so on your way, it's going to be a valley because in the valley is where you're going to have to fight. Y'all ain't saying that. You're going to have to fight your girlfriend, your partner, who you've been sitting by in church for 50 years. You're going to have to fight them. And in the fight, and I'm not talking about no physical fight. I'm talking about a spiritual fight. When they begin to tell you, girl, ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta, you ought to say in the name of Jesus, I bind that spirit up on you right now because we're not
not going to go into 2021 like this. If you want to stay in Egypt, you stay in Egypt, but I'm on my way to Canaan. I've stopped all of that foolishness. And in the house of God, if you're going to Canaan, there's some things you got to stop. There's some people you might have to get away from. Y'all ain't saying nothing in here. You ain't saying nothing up in here. Because it's hard. It's hard for us to understand that. Listen, if somebody come to you with a bunch of foolishness in 2021, you got to tell them, I am not going there this year. Too many people are dying. And we don't know when he's going to call our number. You can be healthy today and out of here tomorrow. So that's why you got to keep your stuff right. I'm trying to tell you, Greater Love, we going to Canaan. We going to Canaan. I'm going, rather y'all going with me. I'm going to Canaan now. I'm not saying that we ain't going to have no ups and downs. We're going to have them. But I'm trying to get there, man. And if I'm trying to get there, there's some things I might have to do. You know, open rebuke is good for the soul.
Right.
Might come some time where I have to say something to you. No, we ain't going there. Stop that. We don't need to do that. We're trying to go somewhere. Ain't you tired? If you've been in 2020, you ought to be tired of living in Egypt. Anybody in here in 2020, you tired of living in Egypt and you want to go to Canaan? Come on out of here. God has already set Canaan up for us, and all we got to do is be obedient to his word, and we can make it to Canaan. But I'm telling you, there is going to be some mountains and some valleys. I need that. I need both of them, because listen, when the devil try to bring something on me, watch me here. When the devil try to bring something on me, I got to say, I've been through that. I've been through that last year, and I ain't going through that this year. Come on, I need the mountains and the valleys. Can I get a witness here? All week long, Nathan.
Yes, sir.
All week long.
Yes,
sir. Well, sometimes we can't say too much to our wives because they want you to go straight, call ambulance and all that, because we scared. I had a pain right here, so it's God.
Yes, sir.
I had a pain right here, and I said, God have mercy. I would get up, and you could fake things out. You know, I was just talking to my wife, just paining and hurting. I went in my room.
Come on, Woody, come on.
Because I told y'all what that old man told me years ago, when I go to the bathroom at night, I pray. So I began to pray that particular night. I said, God, in the name of Jesus, if you want me to preach on Sunday morning, I can't do it with this pain. Lord have mercy. And so Nathan, what I did was, and I'm teaching you right here, I took my hand, Minister Davis, laid it right here in the middle of my back, and I said, in the name of Jesus. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I said, in the name of Jesus, you said by your stripes that I'm healed, and I believe your word. Ain't nobody talking back to me. I believe your word that I am healed. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I said, in the word of God, you said it to me, God, and I believe your word. Y'all ain't saying nothing. And the next morning I got up, y'all called him mercy. I thought about something. Mother Card always used to say, boy, you got any back and body? I'm that back and body. Get you one of them back and body pills, boy. Lord have mercy. And so I went to my cabinet, y'all. After God had healed my back, I said, God, I believe you now, but I'm going to get me a back and body pill. Took me a back and body pill. Y'all ain't saying nothing. And God took everything that was in there. He took it out of there. All I'm saying is I'm on my way to Canaan. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Back in Egypt, I might have been afraid to do that, but I'm on my way to Canaan. I ain't afraid to tell you what I've done. I said, in the name of Jesus, I am healed. I don't know who that word is for, but somebody there needs to be healed. And you can say to yourself, I am healed. I'm a healed man. I ain't going back. I'm telling y'all, I'm not going back. Listen, y'all, listen. Listen, it's in the valley that the sweetest fruit grows. In the valley is where the sweetest fruit grows. God help me. Watch me here. Watch me here. You want to know why? That's because it's watered by the streams that flow from the mountains. You read in your Bible from that mountain, that stream that is flowing from. You know who gave that water? Jesus gave the water. And so when Jesus gives the water, that water is flowing. And Jesus said in the word in John chapter 15 and verse 8, he says, what's it? Jesus said, by this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit. Look at your neighbor and say, in 2021, we got to bear much fruit. You got to bear much fruit because he said, so you will be my disciple. How does he know you are his disciple? Because you're bearing much fruit. Can I tell you something, greater love? This year, Jesus wants you to be more fruitful in service. Jesus wants you to be more fruitful in service. Y'all ain't saying nothing up in here. In serving one another. I don't hear nobody talking. Some of us always want to be served, but we don't want to serve nobody. Can I get a witness here? But you got to be fruitful in your service. If you choiring, be choir. I ain't saying nothing. If you ushering, be ushering. If you deaconess, be deaconess. If you deacon, be deacon. If you a bench warmer, be a bench warmer. Can I get a witness here? But all he wants you to do is be more fruitful. I can't get no help up in here. He don't want you sitting at home. I know you got to do it now. But when God cleared us up, God is saying you need to come back with a new attitude. I need to come back. I said with a new attitude. I can't have that same old foolishness in my life. I got to change. I got to come back to the Sabbath with a new attitude. And I don't care. You better get this in your spirit. I don't care if you don't want to sit by me no more. Because I'm on my way to Canaan. And I can't be stuck in the mud with you. Because some of you want to be halfway in Egypt and halfway in Canaan. No, you got to go all the way to Canaan. Got to go all the way. I ain't fooling with you halfway. Help me, Lord Jesus. Watch this now. Watch this. Watch this. Yeah. Oh, Lord. And he tells us, watch this, how. He says in John 15, 4 and 5, watch as he tells us how to do it. I ain't going to leave you hanging. He says, abide in me and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine and you are the branches, and he who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit, for without me you can do nothing. Without him you can't do nothing. But he says, if you abide in me and I in you, you can bear much fruit. But the problem in the church is nobody want to oh God, have mercy. We don't want to abide in Jesus. Come on, you got to abide. I'm going to read that scripture again because I believe it's worth hearing. Watch this. As the branch cannot bear fruit itself, you can't do it by yourself, unless it abides in the vine. You got to abide in Jesus. Neither can you unless you abide in me. Who's me? Jesus. I am the vine. Jesus is the vine. You are the branches. You're just the branch. And he who abides in me, if you abide in Jesus and I in him and you in him, watch this, bears much fruit. So if you want to bear much fruit, you got to abide in Jesus. Meaning you got to get in the word of God and you got to stay with the script, baby. You can't bear off to the left. You got to stay in straight line. Anybody in there know what I'm talking about? I said straight line with the word of God. And when you learn to stay in line with the word, that's when the blessing of God is going to fall in your life. Thought about something the other day. I said, God, now, You've been good to me.
Yes, sir.
And I thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
I thank you for protecting me.
Thank you, Lord.
From COVID-19.
Yes, sir.
I believe that you will.
Thank you.
But I can't be crazy.
Yes.
Y'all ain't saying nothing up in here.
Yes.
And so I begin to thank God.
Yes,
and I thank God. Listen,
yes,
you know I thank God now?
Yes, sir.
Because he got all of us locked down in the house.
Yes.
Y'all ain't saying that.
Amen.
Everybody locked down. But it's what you do with your lockdown. Y'all ain't saying nothing up in here. I said it's what you do with your lockdown. In your lockdown, you ought to have a better reading of the Bible. You ought to have a more perfect prayer life. Y'all ain't saying nothing up in here. You can't be in the lockdown and be doing everything else. Get on your knees sometime. Wear out them knees while you at home. God needs to hear the prayers of the saints of God in his ear, lifting up each other, not tearing down. I can't help it in the midst of a pandemic. In the midst of people dying. In the midst of people dying. You would think the saints of God would rise to the next level and see that people are dying. And you would leave Egypt and try to go to Canaan. But some people in the house would rather stay in Egypt. It's a bad thing. It's a bad thing to stay in Egypt now. I'm trying to tell you something this morning.
Yes, sir.
When we live, watch this.
Help us.
So what kind of fruit is God looking for in your life this year? Paul tells us when we live God's way.
Yes,
I say when we live God's way, watch this. He brings gift into our lives. Much the same way that fruit appears in an orchard.
Oh, yes,
things like affection for others.
Uh-huh.
In endurance about life. Watch this now. Sincerity. We develop a willingness to stick with things.
Yes.
Ooh, God help me right there.
Yes.
I said we develop. I said we develop a willingness to stick with things. And in the body, we don't have the willingness to stick with nothing. Oh, God, you ain't saying that. You get rebuked one time. Watch me here. This is why you're in Egypt. You're in Egypt. We go into Canaan, and you're still in Egypt, and then you get rebuked. This is what you do because you don't want to stick to anything.
Yeah.
They ain't gonna rebuke me. There's a church right around the corner. I can go to. You ain't gonna stick with nothing. But you'll sit in church. I've seen it. You'll sit in church and you'll teach a lesson and folk jumping over benches. And the first time somebody say something wrong to you, you ready to switch houses of God. But can I tell you something? You can switch churches all day long, but all you doing is taking that spirit with you to the next house. And if you try to wreck this house, you'll take it to the next house. And you'll try to wreck that house. You ain't saying nothing. If you ain't changed that spirit, you ain't doing nothing but taking it somewhere else. Because you ain't got the willingness to stick it out. I'm mad now. But what you mad for? People are dying. What you mad for? Got no willingness to stick with nothing. I'm going to talk about this thing for a minute. You, watch me here. Watch me here. Now, God has already set up an order.
Yes.
And the reason why we messed up because we don't like all.
No.
We want to be out of all. Yes. You don't want to be in all.
Yes.
You want to be out of order all the time. I do what I want to do, and I do how I want to do it. Well, that's your business if you want to do that. I don't want to do that. I want to be in order because I want the blessing of the Lord to be in my life. And so where you at? I ain't fooling with them.
Yeah.
What you mean?
Come on.
Nah. How you gonna say you love God?
Yeah.
And you ain't fooling with them.
Yeah.
How can I love God and hate Sister Carl?
Right.
The Bible say I'm a liar. How can I love God and can't stand Minister Davis? The Bible says I'm alive and the truth is not in me. I'm going with the word of God. When you hating, the truth ain't in you. Watch me now. You ain't got no willing. You don't stick with nothing. And what's the order? The order is, we gave Joseph, I'm going to the choir, they will. I like starting with the choir because the devil started with it.
Yeah, right.
That's what the devil started.
Yes,
I said, well, I like starting there because the devil.
Yes,
all they say nothing. It's in the Bible if you read the Bible.
Yes,
So the order is, what's the order? Minister Joseph Brown, he's the minister of music, right?
That's right.
We all know that.
Yeah.
So when you go to your job,
yeah.
Your supervisor, it comes from here and it comes down.
Yeah.
And you respect all of that. Because
yeah.
If your supervisor tell you to do something and you get all crunchy, then your supervisor going to the head up man or the head up woman. And they're going to talk to the head woman. And then they're going to put you down in the office. And then they're going to talk to you. You see? And then you're going to get, listen, and most of y'all got more respect for the secular job than you do inside the church.
That's it.
Y'all ain't saying that. Secular, you see, because you got it all twisted. Because the secular job give you some money. The secular job give you a check. But you don't know you get a check from Jesus. Y'all ain't saying that. I said, you get a check from Jesus. Your check is I'm in the land of the living. Your check is I won't put no more on you than you can bear. Your check is when I'm sick, I am healed. You get a check from Jesus too. But you rather take that secular check and put it over the check of Jesus. And so you don't want to go through the chain of command.
Thank you.
I've been here.
Come on, Pastor.
I've been here, baby.
No, you in the house.
He's not going to tell me what to do. You out of order. You out of order. And you still in Egypt. You ain't saying that. You still in Egypt. If you can't respect, oh God, help us. Listen, and if I decided that I'm going to let him be here. That's my decision as the leader. As the Lord give it to me, I give it to them. And so when you decide that you're going to disrespect him, you're disrespecting me. Because what you say, I don't care what you say, Isaac. I don't care what you say, Pastor Grant. I ain't doing what he said. But that's out of order. And you're still in Egypt. Ain't nobody in here. Watch me. Ain't nobody in here. Got no business running over there to down to try to tell him how to play the drum. I'm in the house, y'all ain't saying that. You ain't got no business running over there. You're a choir member and you running over there talking about pop, pop, pop. Sit your behind down because he know how to beat the drum. That's why we pay him to beat the drum. Y'all ain't saying nothing up in here. I'm a preacher like God give it to me. You see, you ain't got no business going there because you out of order. President come to you and say, well, I've already got with Minister Music and we've decided as a group that we're going out and we're going to wear black and red. That's what they said. President, she didn't come. She says, we're going to wear, y'all, we're going to wear black and red. What you doing coming up in there with green and yellow? Y'all ain't saying nothing. You coming up in there with green and yellow. They already told you we gonna wear black and red. And then you get mad because they say you out of order and you can't sing. And what you do is you leave, stay in Egypt because you done got mad now and you done said, I ain't gonna be with them no more. I'm going somewhere else. Well, go on somewhere else because you out of order.
Yes,
you out of order, man. You out of order. God is a God of order. And you all out of order. And then you want to be right. And watch this. Watch me here, church. And they love folks that stay in Egypt.
Yeah.
Y'all better hear me. Because some of y'all don't want to leave Egypt.
Come on,
here it is. girl. Because you, because every choir member got partners.
Yeah.
Every preacher got partners.
Yeah.
Every deacon got partners.
Yeah.
Ushers got partners. Y'all ain't saying that. You got folks that you love more than you love Jesus and all of them. And so they come to you and say, girl, you know, we went over to Cincinnati Church and I had my, it ain't about no colors, it's all about my voice. No, it ain't about your voice. It's about all of them. They told you what to wear. Sit down, but what you'll do is you'll go to your friend that like you. And they ain't gonna say nothing amongst the group. They gonna wait until they get outside. Y'all ain't saying that. Girl, I know, girl. What you mean? Why you feeding into that foolishness? Because you still in Egypt too. And girl, I know, and I, if I was you, and no. What you ought to say to them is, you are out of order. You are out of order. But you scared to say that because that's your friend. That's my posse. I don't want her getting mad at me. You get mad all you want to. Y'all ain't saying nothing up in here. See, God want to do something with our heart. Look at your neighbor and say, God want to convict our heart. And he wants to put some holiness in us. And what's this? What's this now? When you read the Bible, go to Galatians. Go to Galatians with me.
Galatians.
When you read the Bible, I ain't talking about reading your friend. I said read the Bible. Uh-huh. Because a lot of you don't want to get into the Word of God.
Yeah, right.
And I want, oh Lord, in the book of Galatians.
Yeah,
right. Galatians chapter 5.
Yeah, right.
See, this is where God wants us to be at, church.
Yeah.
See, you got to leave Egypt.
Yeah.
And in leaving Egypt, I told you it's not gonna be this easy thing where you just step out and go over there. Because the Bible says you're gonna have some hills and some valleys.
Yeah.
It's in the text. You're gonna have valleys, you're gonna have some stuff that you got to go through. But this is where God is trying to get us at. In Galatians chapter 5. Don't say Isaac said it, just say the Bible said it.
The Bible said.
If you're gonna fight somebody, fight Jesus. The Bible says in Galatians. Watch what he says. Chapter 5. Now I'm talking about the fruit now. We're talking about bearing what? Much fruit. Watch what he says. But the fruit of the Spirit. Uh-huh. That's what we're talking about, right? We talk about the mountains, and I gave you scriptures about the fruit of the Spirit, and we talk about the fruit of the Spirit. So what's it? He said, but the fruit of the Spirit, the first one he got in there is love. God help me, Jesus. The first one he got in there is love. And when you read Deuteronomy chapter 11 and you read up in the text, it talks about the commandment that he gives us. And he wants us to follow the commandment. But the first thing he got in here is love. Why do you think the devil likes to attack us when it comes to us loving one another? Come on, because the devil don't want you to get this. That's why he comes to the house of God. He goes there and he tries to cause disturbance because he don't want us to love. What's it? He says joy, peace, long-suffering. You know what long-suffering is? You get on my nerve, but I got to hang in there. Come on, I'm talking real Bible. You make me mad, but I got to hang in there. And the reason I got to hang in there, because you're a child of God like I'm a child of God. We are brothers and sisters in Christ. We got the same daddy, and his name is Jesus. Y'all ain't saying that now. We're trying to go to the same heaven. And so he says, I got to do long-suffering. Uh-huh. Watch what the Bible says, long-suffering. Uh-huh. Now, what's it? Gentleness. A lot of y'all ain't kind to nobody. You ain't even kind to yourself. Kindness, goodness, faithfulness, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. So this year, when you face a mountain, go through the valley, remember, if you do all of this, that God is with you.
That's it.
And so if I abide in him and he abides in me, when I go through my mountain and my valley, I don't panic in that. Because I know that God is with me. And the reason I know he's with me, because I'm doing what he told me to do. But if you don't do what he told you to do, that's when you go into panic. But if you're doing what he told you to do, you can say, thank you, Jesus. You can say, thank you, Jesus. This year, I'm going to say, thank you, Jesus. Because I'm abiding in him and he's abiding in me. Thank you, Jesus. I might have some valleys. I might have some mountains. But I'm going to stay on the shore. God have mercy. When you stay there, watch me here. Watch me here. Y'all know I like to testify, and then I'm getting out of here. Watch me here. Well, Minister Davidson, Isaiah's father, I told y'all that.
Yeah.
He brought Isaiah through here.
All right.
And him and I, we had some conversations.
All right. All right.
And the first thing I told him, y'all know I like it. I just like to have fun. I said, I can't tell y'all the word I use because I might offend somebody. But I said, listen. So I said, listen, man. Look at me. He looked at me. I said, you took advantage of my daughter, boy, I could take her. And he said, no, Pastor, I didn't do that, man. Why are you saying that? And so him and I, we had a good relationship, right? And so we sat down one day. I said, what kind of job you got, boy? And he told me about the issues that he had when he was younger.
Yeah, come on with
you. You understand what I'm saying? When he was younger, he had some issues.
Yeah.
He had to spend some time in prison.
Yeah.
And so I said, listen, let me tell you something. Look at my eye. It ain't over for you yet.
That's right. Say it again. Say it again.
I said, look at me. It's not over for you yet.
Yeah.
The world might say it's over, but I say it's not over for you yet. I say, this is what I say. If you do like I tell you to do, when you get back to Colorado, I want you to see how God is going to take care of you. You ain't saying nothing up in there. So I'm sitting in my bed, Nathan, one day, and I get a text. Pastor, I got the job. Y'all ain't saying that. You ain't saying that. See, because God will put them people in your life because God know you are a light. And if he put them in your life, you got to be the light that he got. Oh, hear nobody. You got to be the light that shines. You can't be the light to go to talking. And see, a lot of times, the Bible says life and death is in the power of the tongue. What if I had a goddamn tongue and nearly mouth tongue? Oh, man. Well, no, ain't no who's me. If God did it for my daughter, he can do it for you because he has no respect of person. And I thank God.
Yes,
Shonda.
Yes, sir.
I said, boy. And this is what I told him, Sister Scott. I said, let me tell you something.
Stop.
Don't go around your friends. Because friends going to tell you, I wouldn't take this job. But you got a job. You ain't saying that. And I said, get in there and do extra stuff. Do stuff that they ain't even telling you to do. Y'all ain't saying that. I'm going to tell you how to climb the ladder, boy. And when you get up the ladder, look back and say, that little black man told me what to do, and I did it, and look what the Lord has done. I come by to tell somebody, when you're in the mountains and you're in the valleys, you can tell the Lord, thank you. Can I get 10 people in here to stand up and tell the Lord, thank you? Jesus, Karen. look up, when I look to my left, I ain't seen the deacon. Y'all ain't seen him. I haven't seen Deacon Cook since the pandemic. He had surgery, and the Lord brought him through. And I sat in my bed, and I said, God, now you done been good to the boy. When is he gonna bring his bling back to church? And then when I saw him walk through the door today, I just say hallelujah. Y'all ain't saying that. I say hallelujah. Y'all better hear what I'm saying. I say hallelujah. Because God could have took him out of here, but hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Then I looked to my right. I said, that's old Ron over there. And had some issues in life. Been through some mountains. Been through some valleys. But he walked in the house of God. Y'all ain't saying nothing up in here. I come by to tell you now that God has been good. I'm gonna tell again, God has been good. I'm gonna say it again, God has been good. Can I say it one more time? God has been good. If the Lord has been good to you, looked up to Jesus and I said, God, people that pray to love, y'all can say some things and y'all ain't even here. So somebody's packing the wrong news. Somebody's packing the wrong news, and I can't help myself but to say it. If you ain't here, you ought to be quiet, because you don't know what's going on. God has sent a remnant of us to keep the church going on. We are saying hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Hey, Shonda, watch me here. You packing it. You know why you packing stuff from here? Because you still in Egypt. You ain't trying to go to Canaan. And so what you do, and I can't understand it. I can't understand it, Nate, to save my life.
Yeah.
I serve at greater love. I stayed under Pastor Carr. I was obedient. I was a hard-headed boy at some point in time. But I stayed here, man. Because this is where my blessing was at. And I thank God that I stayed. Come on, talk back to me if you can. I'm talking to somebody. And some of y'all need to be quiet, man. If you're going to pack some news, pack this kind of news. The Lord has made a way out of nowhere. You want to pack something, I'm going to pack it for you. The Lord has made a way out of nowhere. The Lord has healed the pastor's body. The Lord has kept us all safe up in here from Corona 19. The Lord has healed some of our bodies. The Lord has brought some of us back from Corona. You want to pack something up? Pack this. The Lord is good. His mercy endures for all generations. I love him. 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 Yeah, go ahead and pack that. Pack that. I told y'all in 2021 I'm new, man. I ain't saying old boy. Pack that. When I hear it, I'm going to call it out. Pack that. You wrong for that? No, I ain't wrong. You call a spade a spade. And if it's a fire, you got to put the fire out. Sometimes I got to put it out all by myself. And guess what? I ain't scared to put it out. I'm not afraid of the devil, because he come to kill, steal, and destroy. And if we let him, I said, if we let him, he'll tear us apart. And so we got to listen. We got to be grateful, great love. Listen, I want to do something here, Joe, before I leave. I want to do something. And I'm doing this because, listen, man, some things I do know. Some things I don't know, but some things I do know. And sometimes I'm an encourager. In 2021, all I want to do is encourage people. Thank God for Brother Harold. Thank God for him. You done got mad. You watching me, you done got, well, I got to call his name every day. Don't worry about it. Listen, thank God for Carrie. I know some things. I'm telling y'all. I'm saying that for a reason. Thank God for her. I mean, really. Because the Bible, listen, man. The Bible says, honor thy mother
and thy father.
Come on, I'm in the Bible, right? That your days may be long upon this earth in which you live. He said, honor them. That's what he said. No matter what mistakes that they made, he said, honor them. You can't get away from the Bible talking about that. He said, honor them. And when I look, I know some things about Karen. So when I look at her, I'm serious, y'all. Sometimes I want to cry, man. Because she got a husband and a family. But she got enough sense to go take care of Edna. And some of y'all can learn from that. She got to push herself. She got to push. Y'all not in her shoes. She got to push. She got to drive it. She got to drive with it. She got to go home. She got to cook. She got to make sure all that. That stuff ain't easy. But at least she does it. And somebody need to learn from that. That's why I said you need to learn. Look at the baby right here. She done got married. She with her mama. Yeah. Darling, she with her mama. Yeah. I don't hear nobody. She's with her mama.
Yeah. Take care of her.
Amen.
Now look at Sister Carla. I love her to death. Some people get mad at that. That sister's crazy. I love her. I love her because, watch me. I served under her husband.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
And I'd be able to talk about it because I can and I'm going.
Thank you, Lord.
I served under her husband. And people often ask me, how Sister Carter is over there? She raising hell? No, she never did. Because what they say is, most of the time, when the husband dies and the wife stays, they raise hell. They'll say, well, my husband did this, and my husband said this, and my husband did. So Scott ain't never in her life. I'm clear the record. She never in her life. Since I've been the pastor of this church, tell me how to do nothing up in here. I'm going to clear the record right here this morning. She ain't never told me that.
Amen.
But watch me here. She ain't afraid as an older lady. I can't say that because she'll get mad.
Tell the truth.
But watch this now. Sister Carla been to church since the pandemic started.
That's right.
I don't like her sitting in the back. I'm glad she came up here because I'll give her a tell you. Come on. Get on up here somewhere by yourself. So she's been here, but watch this now. Her daughter then got back on the choir.
Yeah.
Grandson then came back.
Yeah.
See, I'm going somewhere. See, a lot of times we don't understand. If you stay in Egypt, you can't say what I just said. You couldn't do it because you'd be mad at people. Because you got to listen, my baby right here. Her husband, he works on Sunday, and I'm praying that the Lord release him. My cameraman, I'm praying that the Lord release him. And I'm saying all of this because I don't want you to say, well, he just talk about Harold Williams all the time. When Harold get that million, I'm at least get 50 cents. Y'all understand? Oh, When he get that million, I'm gonna at least get 50 cents. Why won't I talk about it? But I thank the Lord, and thank the Lord for, and y'all just let me get it out, I'm going for real. Curtis' wife and daughter. Thank y'all. They've been steadfast, been coming. I thank you. Kay, all y'all who do intercessory prayer, thank you. Joseph, you're playing. John, Rosalyn, Dow, thank you. Choir, praise team, thank you. Watch this. And this is my biggest thing. And I want us to give this glory because I'm getting ready to go. We ain't never in the history of Greater Love had a white person to come. And stay. Took some hits from some of y'all. She ain't paying you no mind. She kept coming and she kept on singing. Y'all ain't saying that up in here. I said, y'all ain't saying that up in here. See, if you want to give God some glory, let's give God some glory.
Convict us in these last days.
Yes.
If you're not in the Word, you can be lost.
Yes.
Yeah.
You could be.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
You could be manipulated.
Yes. Yeah.
You could be misled.
That's right.
And you will be on your way to hell.
Right.
You got to have the Word today.
That's right.
At this time, if there's someone watching today who knows in your heart that you're not saved, you can be saved today. This is the most important decision you will ever make in your life.
Yeah, right.
As I pray the sinner prayer,
yeah,
and you pray with me, and you believe in your heart what you say with your mouth, you will be saved today. Repeat after me. Heavenly Father,
Heavenly Father,
I'm a sinner.
I'm a sinner.
I'm asking you to forgive me,
forgive me
of my sins.
I believe
in my heart
that Jesus
is your son.
He died
on the cross
for my sin.
He was buried.
He rose
on the third day.
He now
in heaven.
Sitting
at your right side,
interceding
on my behalf. Jesus,
I'm inviting you
to come live in my heart,
to be my personal
Lord and Savior. Jesus,
you promised me
once I make you my personal
Lord and Savior,
the Holy Spirit.
Have your way in my life.
Take complete control over my life.
Help me to faithfully
Father, living God,
and do the will
of Jesus.
Of
Every day. Jesus,
Jesus,
I need you.
I'm saved.
I'm saved.
I've been washed
in the blood
of Jesus.
Thank you,
Heavenly Father,
for loving me
enough
to save my life.
In Jesus' name,
we pray.
Amen.
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 Now, while they play the invitational song, there's someone here today who is not saved and you want to rededicate your life to God, you're looking for a church home, you can come and just stand here. We ain't got to pray with you. I need you to stand in agreement with greater love that you want to become part of greater love. We can do this other stuff later, all the other things you do. But if you know that you don't have a church home, while they pray today, just come and stand right here. And greater love can become your church home.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
Will you come today?
Thank you.
Pastor Grant, he recognized Deacon Cook, but I want to recognize Sister Mathias Cook. I want to recognize Sister Cook. She here today with her husband. Amen. Is them visiting you guys with you, Sister Cook? Tell them to sign up. They visitors. Amen. Y'all give a hand. These are 10 folks. Sister Cook, 10 folks. They're going to get married sometime this year. Is that right? In June? In June. Amen. Amen. Come on, Pastor.
Contribution sheets are currently being mailed out. You know, like you used to go to the finance room, but they ain't doing that this year because of COVID. So they mailed out your contribution, and if you don't receive yours, please contact us and make sure we have your current address, meaning contact Ms. Carla, Ms. Johnny, or one of them in the back. If you didn't get it, make sure that they got the right address. Then you can contact them through email. The email is greaterlovebc@att.net. Lowercase, greaterlovebc@att.net.
Or you can call Ms. Johnny Fowler at 512-825-4847. Don't send money through the Cash App. Just go through the Cash App. Don't put no money in the thing. All you get with the deacons out there, and they'll take your money and put it in the proper place. You don't want to send no cash. Listen, now I told you about the contribution on sheet. Listen, one thing I want to announce is we're getting ready to do something here for Ms. Baptiste. We helped Mr. Ron. Come on, y'all. Come on. See, when you do this, you do Bible.
That's it.
You do Bible, because the Bible says that we're supposed to be so in tune together when nobody hurts.
That's it.
And Sister Baptiste,
come on,
I got to say it, through Pastor Card and through me, been a faithful tither at this church. Bring it to the storehouse where there might be meat. She's been a faithful tither at this church. And now she got hit with this thing, and nobody knew it. I didn't know it. You didn't know it, but God knew. And now we're getting ready to have a fundraiser for her. And it's called a birthday bash drive-up fundraiser for Sister Laura Baptiste. We got some tentative date, and the tentative date is February the 16th from 3 to 5 p.m. That's tentative now. Right at the Greater Love Baptist Church parking lot. We're gonna have the drive-through thing for them. And I said to myself, this is what I said. I think it's gonna be a birthday. I'm gonna do extra for her birthday, because I'm her pastor.
Amen.
So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put my in there for her bash, but I'm gonna do extra for her birthday.
Amen.
That's what I'm gonna do. And I pray to God, if I can get 10 of y'all to follow me, then she can have a good birthday. But it's all her bash is going toward something that they need at the house, some kind of walkway thing. And our goal is $5,000. That's our goal. Our goal is $5,000. And I don't know what we raised for Ron. I think about 10. So we can do 5. And listen, it's Bible. It's Bible. Ooh, I've been teaching it on Monday night, if you've been listening. It's Bible. And so if all of us come together, watch this. If all of us come together, then nobody will be hurting.
Yeah.
If one person do it, then we, you know. But if all of us come together, so let's get there for this celebration. And then I want to say this, y'all. See, sometimes, watch this here. I'm gonna live what I preach in 2021. I don't care who say what, I'm gonna live this thing. Because Jesus is coming back. And I believe it's soon. Listen, the second Sunday in February, we normally go, our first outing is over to Pastor Levels. We're not gonna go. You know, we in the pandemic. We in the whatever. So what I decided to do was, I decided that I would bring them by Greater Love, sit them outside, and then we gonna have a drive-by thing. We gonna have a drive-by thing for them. And if you, it's gonna be from like 2 to 4 on that particular Sunday. So if you wanna come and drive by and do something for Pastor Level and Sister Levels, I want you to come and do that.
Amen.
And let me tell y'all something, Greater Love.
Amen.
I wasn't here when Greater Love first started. All I got was history. All I know is they was there over here, and somebody donated chairs, and then it was in a building here, and somebody said it was raining in the building, but somebody donated to you. The Bible says, whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap.
Yeah.
So if you sow some good seeds, you're gonna reap something.
Amen.
Somebody helped you when you didn't have it,
Now sometimes, now the Lord is turning it around where you got the opportunity to help somebody else.
Yeah.
I love them. I love going where I go. Everybody won't go. You know why? Because it ain't a big paycheck.
Amen.
Y'all ain't saying nothing.
Amen.
But if you go and you give and you plant a seed where there's a need, then God can do something for you. And so I love them, and I gave them that opportunity. They called me this morning. I said, well, we're going to make it happen. We are going to make it happen. And I thank God in 2021, I don't have to hear all that. Well, I ain't hearing nothing. I said, we're going to do it. I already told them we're going to make it happen because I love them and I love Jesus, and Jesus wants us to love his people. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Now, watch this now. We're going to have a funeral here Saturday at 11 o'clock. It's a DJ that was on. She was at KAZI, Lady J. And some of y'all look, Lady J. She'd be on KAZI. She died. Her funeral will be here Saturday at 11 o'clock. And we're hosting that. And what was you going to say, Mr. Davis? You was going to say something to me. Yes, sir. He wants to say one thing. I'm going
to
let him say
it. I just want to explain to you why we need this $5,000 for Sister Baptiste. Because some of you think about your father, but she lost one of her legs. So she had to take her bed and move it from upstairs to downstairs. We need to get her a chair lifter. So she will be able to sleep in her bed upstairs. Mm-hmm. This lifter will take her from downstairs to upstairs. Right now, she don't have no way to get upstairs.
Amen.
And this is why we need this money.
Yeah.
Because she need a chair lifter.
Amen.
So now you know why we need the money. So now you might freely give. Because next time it could be me or you.
That's right.
And I just want to explain to you. We just ain't talking about, we talking about she needs something.
Mm-hmm.
She need that lifter.
Amen.
I was out there visiting her, I think it was Tuesday or Wednesday. And her bed is downstairs. I sit there and talk to her for about an hour. She in good spirit. She ain't asking us for this lifter, but we gonna give it to her because she need it. She very humble. She in good spirit. She got some joy. And she told me something. She said, Minister Davis, one day, you know, she laughed. She'll laugh with you. She said, I'm gonna get another leg. She said, but first I got to learn how to walk before they give me another leg. She said, but Minister Davis, they gonna have to give me a brown leg. Because they ain't going to have no mixed back legs. You know, I'm just saying, she in that kind of spirit. And what I'm saying to you, though, Sister Baptiste has been a faithful servant here.
Amen.
Wherever you ask her to do something, she did it. And she didn't complain. And what I'm saying to us, she need this now. We don't need to wait around saying, well, whatever you can do, do it right now. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you, preacher. He goes. He's the one that go to all of the seniors' house, take care of business for me. And I'm grateful for that. So he got the right to stand and say what he just said. So thank you, preacher. I appreciate that. Let's get on this drive, and then I know you're saying, well, yeah, baby. Then we're going to have to turn back around and try to give the preacher over there. Yeah, let's be a blessing. Do what you can do.
I'm
not asking you for no amount. I'm just saying do what you can to do what you can do. And listen, God will bless you because you're blessing somebody else that needs it. Ron is a great example of what great love can do. He's a great example, man. And see, some of y'all, we still riding the blessing of that because of what you did for Ron.
Amen.
I'm telling you, man, what you do for others, God will make it happen for you.
That's it.
The great Lord, we thank you for staying. Thank you. I thought I was going to be blown out of the shuffle today with the calls that I got. I guess because of the rain, some didn't show up. But I want to thank God for the numbers that we have been keeping here at Great Love.
We're right in the mix with the CDC, with the CDC numbers. We're right there. So I'm grateful to God for that. Thankful for him keeping us here and keeping us safe. I know some of you football fans saying, shut up, Pastor Grant, we need to go home, get our dish together so we can watch the football game. And I'm right there with you. Come on, let's stand and go home. I'm right there with you. Can stand. Minister Davis, come and close us out, man.
Last days.
Yes, Lord.
And we thank you, Lord. You've been so good to us.
Yes, Lord.
We a thousand times can thank you enough. May the love of God and the mercy and grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide each and every one of us until we meet again. And the church did say,